I'm like, what do you mean? Like, that's like horrible. That's like puts a damper in my situation. Hey guys, what's going on? It's your boy Sag Glitch, aka Sag. Today I'm bringing you Hanging with Sag / Summer Break vlog, week one and two. I was meaning to get more into this as the summer went along, but we kind of got busy really quick. And so kind of like a breakdown of what's been going on. I have my little notepad because, you know, I forget stuff. I write stuff down, a nice little bit of notes here. But if you hear something in the background, just get over it. It's my nephew and we're kind of hanging out with him. He's kind of chilling right now, and out of respect to my sister-in-law and her family and him and his privacy, you know, I'm gonna try my best to keep him out of videos, and I might throw a picture up, but not unless my wife would okay it through her. So, you know, if that's the case, whatever. If you're upset about it, get over it. I figure you guys would be a little bit understanding and respectful of that nature. So, that being said, let's get right into it. Right, bud? All right. So, Monday, June 3rd, which is, what's today? Wednesday that I'm recording this. It's going up on...
Today's Thursday.
Oh, God. Starting to fly by, guys. Thursday the, what, 12th? 13th. So it is Wednesday the 13th, and I'm recording.
Thursday the 13th.
So today is Thursday the 13th. It is actually almost 2 weeks since the last day of school, and it's probably, when this goes up, it's probably going to be after 2 weeks. You know how it is. You record something, you get it edited, you put it up. But Monday, June 3rd, was the last official day for teachers at our school. Friday prior to that, the 1st was, or 31st, was the last day for students. You know, wouldn't say graduation day because they did that the day before, but you know, the ceremonial day that everybody cries at the end of middle school, which I don't get, but hey, you guys do yourselves. I'm not making fun of you guys that are watching this. I get it, but at the same time, it's a little bit ridiculous. But so Monday comes by, and your boy took 15 minutes to pack his class because I have just a couple posters. We went ahead and took all my resources off the wall, put in my one box and two boxes for the grades and whatnot, and got it in the storage unit immediately. Took me 15 minutes to get everything set up, signed all the paperwork, and turned my key in for the summer, and we're done. Come to my wife's room, which I will say this, I give her a lot of crap, but my wife is very, very big into her job. She throws herself into her work, which every great teacher does. I'm not saying I'm not a good teacher, but at the same time, my wife is one of those people that throws herself into work, and she's a very incredible, extraordinary teacher that, if, you know, I might be biased, but if I had to rank her, she would be number one in the state of Florida, let alone probably the nation. You know, no offense to the other teachers out there, but she puts in the preparation and work and makes connections with all the kids and the family members to make sure that the kids' learning is the best of their abilities. The fact of the matter is that I have students that had her when they were in third and fourth grade that still go and talk to her, goes and connects with her on a daily basis in the middle school after years of having her, says something to a point. But going back to the topic at hand, we go downstairs and my wife has so much stuff in her room, and it's extremely overwhelming, especially for someone who only has to pack one box for the entire year. One and done, you know what I'm saying? Keep it simple, keep it easy. So we actually have like two parents down there helping us get packed up, get everything set, and my wife's parents come over and help. We've rented a 10 by 10 building, which if you guys had to think about it, think about like a jail cell, because literally the dimensions in some jail cells are 10 by 10. It's a pretty big storage area. And we have filled that to about 70-75% capacity. We just had to weigh at it. You know, it was over the weekend we got into the school. The in-laws came up to help us then. We had two cars, and we took three trips back and forth. So technically six total trips back and forth from the school to fill up. And we still weren't done by Monday. Still weren't done. After 5 hours on the weekend coming in and doing that, still weren't done. So we're chipping away every little bit at a time. Still, Monday comes and rolls around about 3-4 o'clock. We're still at it. And we said, you know, enough's enough. We got to stop right now. We'll come back tomorrow, tackle it through tomorrow, and get our work done. Tuesday rolls around. Same deal. Had to get it done. Had to get some things done. We turned in all of our stuff and started wrapping up on my wife's classroom. The problem is, if you guys don't live in the state of Florida, or even if you do, if you guys can see off of the screens or the windows back here, this state is notorious for raining daily, constantly, during the summer. And so we had to deal with that. We had like a couple windows to deal with. And so Tuesday rolls around. We didn't get as much stuff. We were almost done, and we decided to call it. I started getting boxes taped up in a room, just said, screw it, whatever stays, stays, and whatever doesn't go to the storage, we're just going to trust the school does the right thing. So Wednesday rolls around, and I actually had fun, big plan for me. I say big, relatively speaking. A couple of my coworkers and the coaches at the school I work at invited me and some others out for a nice little competition, nice little field day, if you would, at a local arcade down in Lake Worth. We get there. The guy that I rode with we were the first ones that were there. And as we got out of the car to meet the other guy that pulled up, three camp buses. And that's another thing. We didn't take into account that summer camps were going on. But three different camps rolled up. And we walked inside for a second. There's like all these little kids on the outdoors looking in, like, you know how you do it. You know, I mean, listen, Sam, if you're watching, you and your brother both know how that works, because you did it all through the years, my first year at the school. But so as we sit there, we see these kids looking in like little zombies, and we're like, it's kind of weird. So we decided to head outside for a couple minutes in the parking lot where the last two coworkers are pulling up. And we're just kind of sitting there discussing a couple of things, what's been going on, enjoying the first couple of days of summer. And we kind of got to thinking about it. And finally, the coach said, you know, hey, is this kind of weird? And we're kind of looking, and we're like, we're all above the age of 30. And we're all kind of like looking around, it's five of us. And we're like, yeah, to be the only kid, to be the only adults other than the camp counselors there, that is kind of weird. So we got to thinking, put our minds to ease, and we collaboratively thought of basically mini golf, which they did say that there was like a mini golf course like 5 miles down the road. So we decided to do that, and it actually turned out to be a lot of fun. And again, I used to actually be pretty good at mini golf. I mean, thinking about like, and not to say it like this, but thinking as a math teacher, you can think of like the different angles to bounce stuff off of and stuff like that. You know, this would be the case if the fact is that the course wasn't poorly set up. The bricks that kind of lined the holes up were very low, and the balls were easily bouncing off of it. And we played actual like golf rules where if it went off the course or when you dropped it, that's a stroke, and the next stroke. So if you went off course, it's basically a two penalty stroke. So after the first two holes, I stroked out. The fact is that I think it was a 6-stroke maximum per hole. And your boy was already at 12 at hole 3. I started to make a little bit of a comeback towards the middle of the end of the actual play, but the fact of the matter is that when you start bad, sometimes it's too hard to catch up. So, you know, that's why it's always good to play great through the holes. And I'm a very competitive person, so being put back, it put on my competitive side to make me get fourth place out of the five people that are there. So, you know, I was not happy with my performance, but at the same time, it's about having fun. And I started having fun at the end, towards the end of it, because I wasn't upset anymore. I knew that I was already behind. So Saturday, we had a class that we had to go to. And then Sunday, we headed up here in Orlando for the week. We had to get everything in order. We had to watch my mother-in-law. My wife had to watch her get used to the whole situation of babysitting, because we're going to be taking over and helping throughout the summer. So Sunday, we got up here. The plan was to start making a basketball series. And there's a hoop in the neighborhood. And my in-laws and my sister-in-law both live in the same neighborhood. And I've actually been able to go out and play on the basketball hoop out there. It's actually a decent court for it being a small neighborhood. And the plan was to make a little series, which I'm still in the process of making. You guys will see it. It's probably cringeworthy first couple episodes, but you'll see my progress going through. I'm a big guy, don't expect much, but I was so hyped to start making these videos. And the fact of the matter is, when I said something or brought it up to my wife, my mother-in-law chimed in saying, "Oh, hey, someone broke the backboard of the goal." And I'm like, what do you mean? Like, that's like horrible. That's like puts a damper in my situation. There's actually a bunch of kids that play in this neighborhood, especially towards the middle afternoon to evening. And the fact of the matter that the games actually get pretty rowdy from what I hear. I've only played one game here with a bunch of kids, and it was only four of us total. It was me and this little guy, and then two high schoolers. And actually, most of the kids around here are actually really friendly, very nice kids from what I've seen. I know it's a very skewed perception, but based off of those guys, they're pretty cool. So, you know, I was planning on going out early because it gets hot in Florida, and I'm a big guy. I sweat immediately. So imagine that on top of it being like 100 degrees out. That's not a good look for me. But so I was planning to do that, but apparently one day it got out of hand. There was a nice basketball game going on. Someone went up for a dunk, and it was a nice hoop. Very well-maintained hoop. And I guess someone went up for a dunk and either hung on for too long or let it go or slammed it down too hard and it smashed the glass in the background. And kids were still playing, and the property basically said that it's a liability issue for the kids to be out here with broken glass, so they had to take the entire hoop down. Now, they do have an order for it to be back up, but it was my you know, I'm very habitual, or if I have a plan in place, I want to stick by it. So that kind of put a damper on everything. So when I went inside or later that night, I started researching like public basketball courts in the local area. Hey, buddy. You getting tired? Yeah, you are. You're so cute, though. It was my job or my opportunity to go online later that night and look up public basketball courts in the local area. It's not as easy as what you think. I mean, there's Elite Hoops here in Orlando, which, you know, showcases AAU travel teams, which are like basically mini pro basketball players. They got guys that I think Elite has their own AAU team, but there's kids like from Ball for Life and stuff like that, or Ball is Life. I think it is. I don't know. One of our guys on the basketball team actually is on that travel team for 13-year-olds. So, but so that was coming around, and that was kind of like put a damper on everything. Monday rolls by. We're just getting in the effort. I'm trying to help out with the little guy that you guys hear in the background. And then Tuesday comes, and Tuesday was the last day of this week that the in-laws, my mother and father-in-law, were going to be here before taking back. Hey, buddy. Oh, be careful.
Can you help me?
Yeah. All right, so we're back. Had to get the little guy situated, but Tuesday was the last day that my mother and father-in-law were going to be here. It was the last day of getting everything in to get a proper understanding of what to do, the time limits, you know, whatever for him. And again, he's the main focus of everything. That's partially why we're here. But my wife and mother-in-law went out to Target. So my father-in-law was actually upstairs working from home, answering phone calls, doing stuff on the computer. I was working my butt off being a good student, finishing up this teaching license that I have to do. But my wife and mother-in-law go to Target, and they come back, and my wife gets out this, you know, this receipt and shows me $180. $180. And 20 of it was spent on her. So I know what you're thinking. Say, what the f- did she buy? Well, this shirt, for instance, is pretty legit. I know what you're saying. These shirts are actually like, I think the company there is called Goodfellas. I'm not sure. But this shirt, as you guys can see, if I can get it nice and, ooh. This shirt's actually from a company called Goodfellas. I think they have a brand deal with Target only. And it's like some of the most comfortable shirts ever. But so she bought me like 6 or 7 pairs of shirts. Or pairs. 6 or 7 shirts just of this brand. They're like the most comfortable shirts in the world. She bought me 3 or 4 pairs of athletic shorts, which they're Champion shorts. But I'm not really like a brand snob. I mean, I can be sometimes. I typically stick with Nike or Under Armour, but this brand, Champion brand, has been coming back in style, and it's more about comfortability. And she knew that I was wanting to do a lot of athletic stuff, a lot of like stuff that's gonna make me sweat. And you can't keep wearing stuff that you sweat in all day. It's about hygiene, guys. If you sweat, you need to shower. Simple as that. But that's bad. Simple as that. But she went out, she got me that stuff. We actually did end up going to the basketball courts later that day. It was like 3:30-ish, 4 o'clock, and actually our nephew Owen, he was actually not with us that day. So we went out there. There's a bunch of people out there. Only 2 of the 4 courts were being used, but I kind of wanted to do a whole training video to actually show you guys how bad I was and how hard work can get you a little bit better. So I didn't really want to film it with people around, plus I was kind of nervous, and my wife, didn't even want to get out of the car. She was a little bit nervous of being there and people watching. So it wasn't something to be embarrassed about, but the fact is that we're a little weird and we kind of worry about whatever people think. So we put that off a day. So I think that was for the best, because as you guys will see, your boy sucks. But Wednesday comes around. That's actually the day that we start babysitting. Today is Thursday. We had our nephew for ourselves. We had to fend for everything, and it actually went very well. My wife's a very easygoing caregiver. He's a pretty cool dude. I'm not gonna lie. Like, he's young, and I could be biased, but he smiles so much. He's such a cool dude, and honestly, I didn't think I'd be making as much of a connection with him as I am. But it's always a good thing. So, you know, always make sure that you guys are open to new people in your life. Make sure you guys are loving. But one thing I will say, we took him for a walk, which was a nice big walk to get him sleeping. And it was like 2 miles, I think. Something like that. It was close to 2 miles around the entire neighborhood, like the entire community out there. I don't know if you guys can hear, but it's raining. So I'm trying to wrap this up. But took him for a 2-mile walk, and we got him settled in. He was asleep. He was knocked out. You know, we sat down. I watched him, even though he was sleeping. I watched him while my wife went upstairs, showered, and came back. When she came back, it was like roughly about 30 minutes afterwards. We got him fed. And then I decided to take that time. It was like 10-something. I took that time to go to the local park. I'm a little bit more, you know, to be honest with you now, I'm a little bit more out of shape. This is being filmed after the fact is I did it. I'm a little bit more out of shape than what I thought. But the fact of the matter is I'm not going to give up on it. It's one of the few things that get me super active here. I'm sore from it. I haven't been, my back's been killing me lately. I haven't been stretching. So got to start on that. But one bad thing that did happen. As much of a connection as I made with them, I do horribly with stuff like body functions, like, you know, changing diapers, not me. Throw up, not me. And so I'm sitting there, and I'm holding him, he's smiling, he's interactive, he just ate. And then all of a sudden he's putting his hands, like, he has a bad habit about putting his hands in his mouth. I don't know if it's just him or all babies. But when his pacifier wasn't in, he put his hand in his mouth. He started puking everywhere. And so my wife hands him to me to grab something. And then he took the time to go look at me. He goes, "Bleh." And I was like, oh, like, don't, no. Don't do throw up because your boy's going to run away. Throw up in my classroom, throw up in my house, I'm out. I'm not cleaning it up. That's gross. You know, I clean up the dog's poop. That's fine. But throw up, not coming. If you throw up, I'm throwing up. Simple as that. But the fact of the matter, guys, is I'm going to do better keeping these vlogs updated, keeping it from a different day perspective. I'm going to actually do it when I get a chance. But if I don't, it'll be like this, like a little summarization of a wrap-up of 2 weeks. But I hope you guys are enjoying this. I hope you guys are going to enjoy me putting out the video of from Scrub to Dub, and I don't know what you're saying. Seg, you're already cringy. Well, it's partially why you guys are here, right? With that being said, I've been having a great summer so far. I hope you guys, if you guys are in school and you're having summer break, I hope you guys are having a great summer. If you're, you know, just working and having the weekends off, again, hey, it's still the summer, guys. Enjoy your time. Get some pool, get some sun, get out of the rain. And with that being said, I'm logging out. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll catch you next week with another update. I'll catch you Friday with the first episode of Scrub to Dub. And get you guys some gameplays in between that. With that being said, I'm signing off. Have a great weekend. Peace.